Hey everybody, this is the Praetorian. I'm doing my 10 a.m. video out in my backyard, and it is a pretty good time. You can hear the crickets chirping, everything. I like to do these at night, that way, or on the back porch with the light off, because I enjoy sitting in the dark. I find it pretty enjoyable. Gives me time to think and talk to you. I've been having issues on my videos on YouTube. It's not YouTube, it's actually me, my scheduling. I keep wanting to set up a video for 10 a.m. and 10 p.m. and I was doing okay for the first 2 or 3 days, but now, man, I seem to be late on getting them in. I had to turn my 10 p.m. video last night into YouTube this morning at around maybe 6 o'clock, and I was just barely able to finish my 10 a.m. video this morning for 10 a.m. And that didn't come out at 10 a.m. like I'd planned, because when I went to schedule it, I scheduled it for the wrong day and time. It was supposed to open up tomorrow at 8:25, so I'm working on getting all that straightened out in my head. It's pretty interesting, you know. I thought I had all this stuff packed down, and it's crazy with all the things that I've been doing concerning the editing of the film, and the film's not really that good, so I apologize for that. Later on, I'll get some better video equipment and stuff, but at the moment, I'm just working with the best I've got. My iPad, you know, my Movie Maker, and my Wondershare Pro, and that's all I've been using. I use a converter on Google to convert my videos from GPP. That comes off of my iPad onto Google Docs. I use a converter from there to change it from GPP to MP3. Then I have to use the MP3 audio with the video that I make on my computer. I have to add both of those together on my Movie Maker and then edit everything in audio. Then, after I'm done doing that, I have to take what I created right there and put it on my Wondershare Pro so that I can convert my Windows Media video into MP4. That's just so I can upload it onto YouTube. After I get on YouTube, I write out my description. I have all my presets there, so all I have to do other than do my tags is go in and put in my closed captions and things of that nature. And I use my IQ, Video IQ, VidIQ, to find the best tags to put on there. After I do all that and I have it going and it's ready to post, or it does get posted, I should say, that's when I have to share it with everybody. So I have it automatically to where it shares to Twitter and to Google+. But then I have to go and share my videos to Minds and Facebook. Well, that gets to be pretty interesting, because I'm pretty sure, I'm not definite, but I'm pretty sure that it's not posting my videos on Twitter automatically. I think it's doing that when I go and post on Facebook, and then I have to like my video after I post it on there. It's a complicated issue, so it's time consuming and I'm figuring it out. I'm also, when I'm editing, I'm really starting to pick up on a lot of things when it comes to the way I talk. Like just now I said so. And when I'm and then the hacking, I go and shit like that. But I'm starting to notice all that, and I'm working on it, realizing where things are messing up in my grammar. The whole issue of raising my voice and sounding better is something I think I'm going to have to resolve with a mic, something that picks up on my voice a little bit better, because I've been lifting my voice up on a lot of it, and it does sound better, but it's still not loud enough. I done that, and then I'm going through and I'm working on my story, or my series, the one that I was telling everybody about. It's the system we know according to time. I'm on part two now. I did the banks and the bankers on my first part. This time it's about the socialist movement that started in Europe. It's pretty interesting too, because I've gone through this before, but I never paid attention like I did now, especially since I'm having to edit everything. And like, I'm noticing a lot about what I've with subversion, you know, and that's a big thing that stuck out to me. So I'm gonna probably put a video up about subversion, because I have some good stuff on that, especially when it concerns what we've done as well as what Russia has done. Then I also noticed things that are happening today compared to back then. I mentioned that in my last video. I find it pretty ironic that those things are happening again, you know. And I don't see it as a coincidence. There's something behind that. We have groups here in the United States that are actually doing old socialist games, and they're playing with our lives. And I think that a lot more people in this country should be waking up to what's going on, not just our country, but in Europe too. You know, they're just saturated with socialism. It's pathetic. How many times do you have to be bombed by terrorists to figure out that these people are just going to walk into your country and take it over because you're too busy worrying about social problems? That's ridiculous. Oh, yeah. And then I'm looking at the other people that played a part in the beginnings, just before World War II, like Czechoslovakia. You know, everybody's under this impression that Czechoslovakia was forcibly taken over by the Soviet Union, and that, I don't see that as what actually happened. I mean, the guy that I've been talking about in there, Tomas Masaryk, he was a socialist. He was 100% behind the socialist movement. To me, I would believe more that he just turned his country over to this Soviet Union. I don't see that as a fact that they were forced into the Soviet Union at all. You know, just things like that I picked up on. This next one, it's going to get more in depth. It's going to start talking about, you know, the strategies that happened with countries when they were trying to isolate Germany and keep them from, you know, building a military and, you know, things of that nature. Screwing them around with, like, countries that were around them were, like, setting up borders between Germany and other countries like Russia. And like Masaryk, the guy I was just mentioning, you know, after Tsarist Russia fell and the Bolsheviks were in power, he ran to Russia and started negotiating and creating, you know, alliances and allies and stuff there. So that's another issue that I do want to bring up about the Bolsheviks, because that's some pretty heinous stuff that went on there, and a lot of people don't know about that. You know, we hear about World War II and we hear about the Holocaust. There was a lot of crazy stuff going on even before the Holocaust. I mean, there was some evil, evil stuff going on, especially with concerns to the Bolsheviks. They were a bad, bad group of people. That's later on down the line. I'm just now starting to talk about the socialist diplomats that were in power in that part of Europe before World War II even started. And I've finished talking about Plume. You know, he wasn't that bad of a guy when it's in comparison to all the other ones, but I do see how he turned a blind eye to his own policies when it came to Germany as well. You know, he felt that equality was important, yet when that Germany owed reparations to him, he was willing to send his military into Germany and force labor on the German people in order for them to pay back war reparations. That I don't agree with. I think that was really, really uncalled for. He overstepped his bounds there. So it makes a lot of sense to me why there would be resentment by the Germans to want to go to war and literally over everything that happened during that time period, I could understand. But my whole, the thing I have an issue with, and I can't understand, is what I'm basically saying, is why was Poland such a big issue for Germany and Hitler? I had a friend of mine that was up there, or lives in Poland, and he said that it's the region, you know. Strategically, Poland is in the right place where it's got a port to the ocean or to the waters, and it's in between Russia and all of the major areas in that region. So I don't know, that might have been it. I'm going to check into that a lot more too. I still haven't been able to get to some parts of it. And like I said, a lot of the stuff I've been talking about and the things I will talk about, that's not even half of the story. So if you guys know more information, feel free to share it with me, because I'm all about research and I love doing this stuff. So don't hold out on me. There's something that I miss in the story, you know, add it. Let me know about it. I'll be more than willing to research it and put it in my videos and share it with people, because people need to know this stuff. I really believe that there's a big chunk of history during that time period that's missing. You can go back and look, and there's a whole bunch of it that just hasn't been mentioned at all. I think that's a shame, and it needs to be talked about. As a matter of fact, there's a whole lot of history, period, that's been missing that should be talked about. Well, I'm coming close to my 15 minutes, so I'm going to get off of here and figure out something else to talk to you guys about later on. You have a good day, and talk to you later. Bye.